Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part two of decimal notation and place value, and we do these problems on this video. How would we write 0.413 as a fraction? In other words, what does this mean? So there's more than one digit here. Let's start off by using the place value idea and writing the three fractions, each depending on where each digit is. So the four, it's one place after the decimal point, so that is 4/10. So we've got 4/10. Okay. The one, it's two places after the decimal point, so we're going to add 1/100, that's in the hundredths place. And the three, that's three places after the decimal point, so we're going to add 3/1000. Remember, three places after the decimal, three zeros after the one in the denominator. Right, now here's where you have to remember how to add fractions. You have to have a common denominator. What's cool about decimals is that the denominators are all powers of 10, 10, 100, 1,000, etc. So it's really easy to get a common denominator. And what would it be? What's the smallest number 10, 100, and 1,000 go into? It's 1,000. So I'm going to multiply this first fraction by 100 over 100 to get 1,000 in the denominator. And the second fraction I can multiply by 10 over 10. So what does that give me now? This gives me 400 over 1,000. Plus 10 over 1,000 plus 3 over 1,000. Now that I have a common denominator, I can add the numerators. It's 413 thousandths. So this is how we write 0.413 as a fraction. In fact, this is how we should read it. It's 413 thousandths. Now, how could you go directly there? You take the part after the decimal and you read it. It's 413, and you look and see the place value of the last digit showing. So the last digit is three places after the decimal, so in the denominator will be a one with three zeros. So if we wanted to write this in words, we would say 413 thousandths. So you just read the whole number, 413. And then three places after the decimal means we're thousandths, and remember to put the TH. Let's try one more like that. All right. Now, we could also do expanded form first if you forget how to do this by saying, well, the five's in the tenths place and the six is in the hundredths place and get a common denominator. Tenths, which is going to give you 50 hundredths plus 6 hundredths, which is 56 hundredths. Okay, that's sort of the long way to do it. Let's go directly. How would we figure this out? Well, you just read the number that is after the decimal point, or write it in the numerator. So it's 56 goes in the numerator. And then there's two places after the decimal. So it's one with two zeros. And that's all you have to do. And how do you read it? 56. Some people put a dash six. I don't think you really need the dash. 56 hundredths. What about if you've got a number like this? Okay. Well, this is split up. We've got the whole number part and we've got the decimal part. So we begin to write this as a mixed number. The whole number part is 302, right? Exactly the same number. And then what's the fractional part? Well, the part after the decimal is just 45. All we have to decide is how many zeros to put after that one in the denominator. There's three places after the decimal point, so we've got three zeros. And then if you wanted to write this out in words, it's 302. Don't write 302, just 302. And is what separates the whole number part from the fraction part, and 45 thousandths. So now you know how to write decimals in fractional form and to also write them in words. All right, we're going to go the other way around now. We're going to take a number written in words and we're going to try to write it as a decimal and then also as a fraction or mixed number. All right, let's look at the first one. 18 thousandths. Now, notice there's no whole number part here. There's no word and anywhere. That's one clue. So you only have thousandths. So remember a thousand, remember what a thousand looks like. It has three zeros. So we know there are going to be three places after the decimal point. Okay? So if I were going to write a number with three places after the decimal point, just imagine this is what it looks like. You'd have three places, and you need to write the number 18 as far to the right as possible. So the 18 would go here, which means we'd have to fill in a zero before the decimal point. So here's how I would write this. I could write that as, sometimes it's easier to write the 0.018. That way it's easier to see the decimal point. So we've written it as a decimal. Now, how do we write that as a fraction? It's actually easier. To take it from here, 18 thousandths means you've got 18 over 1,000. All right, let's look at the second one. Notice this time, there's the word and here. So this is broken up into a whole number part and the decimal part. For the whole number part, we have 14. And then we've got 7/10. Well, remember 10, the number 10 only has one zero, so there's only be one place after the decimal, and that'll be the 7. So that's how I write that as a decimal number. Now, how can I write that as a mixed number or a fraction? It's a mixed number, right? It's a whole number and a fractional part, so I could write that as 14 and 7/10. Now, if you wanted to write it as an improper fraction, you could. Remember how to do that? You could do 10 times 14, which is 140, plus 7. That would be your new numerator. And you keep the denominator of 10. So these all mean the same thing. This is written as in decimal form. This is written as a mixed number. And this is written as an improper fraction. Now there's an easier way to go directly from a decimal to an improper fraction. You simply write the number without the decimal point. So you see 147, you simply write 147 for the numerator, and then you see how many digits are after the decimal point. There's only one, so you write one with one zero, and you go directly to 147 tenths. Let's do that on this next one. We have 50 and 9/100. How about if I write it as a mixed number first? See the and, we have a mixed number, right? Writing as a mixed number first, it would be 50, that's the whole number part, and 9/100. So I've got 9 in the numerator and hundredths, right? Okay, so that's how if I were going to do the fraction part first. Let's do the decimal. 50 and 9/100. So again, the whole number part's 50. I've got 9/100. Now, 100 has two zeros, so I know I've got to have two places after the decimal point. And I want 9 to be written in here, so I need to write 9 all the way over to the right. So we have 09, 50.09, which really means 50 and 9/100. Best to read it that way to really reinforce the idea that that's what this means. Right? 50.09 means 50 and 9/100. Okay, so let me just write this out without those little lines. 50 and 9/100. Okay, now how would I write that as an improper fraction the way I just showed you? Try it. Or what do? We just write the number that we see, ignore the decimal. So I have 5, 0, 0.09. There are two places after the decimal, so I have a 1 with two zeros. That's how I would write it as an improper fraction. Notice you would get the same thing if you would have taken this mixed number and done 100 times 50, which is 5,000, and add 9 to get 5,009 in the numerator. Okay, so we have learned how to write decimals as fractions or mixed numbers. We've learned how to take it from words to decimals, from decimals to words. So hopefully we've got a pretty good idea how to go back and forth between these formats. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.